Egyptian adventure. Nadim and Anya came to play. Albeth and Tibeth up. Nadim had a book about the ancient Egyptians. It isn't just a book to read. Say Nadim, it's a special sort of book. It is a model book. Say Nadim, he opened it to show everyone. I get it, said Tib. You press out of the ships, then you fold and glue them to make a model. The book had lots of ships to press out and fold. Nadim pointed to one. Can you see what this will be? Yes, kid, of course we can, said Anya. This will be a pyramid. She found some glue, then Nadim pressed out of Shabbos and the other began to fold. Then first they made the pyramids. Anya had a difficult shape to fold. This is a sphinx. This is a sphinx, she said. They pressed out some tiny trees and people. They glued them all onto a sheet of paper and made a scene of ancient Egypt. The children were pleased with it. I'm really pleased with the sphinx, said Anya. At last, the model was finished. It looked so good, they called mom upstairs to have a look. What a good job you made of it, said mom. I like the pyramids, said the sphinx. The sphinx was hard to make, said Anya. Flabby ran into the room. He didn't see the model on the floor, and he thought on it with his big paws. He knocked it over a tree and crushed the sphinx. Oh, Flabby, everyone yelled. Flabby looked unhappy. He knew he had upset the children. Never mind, said Chip. It wasn't Floppy's fault. The sphinx looked even better than before. Suddenly, the magic key began to glow. The key took the children back in time. It took Floppy too. It's not my day, thought Floppy. First, I get into trouble. Now it's a magic adventure. The magic took them back to ancient Egypt. They were standing by a pyramid. The pyramid was still being built. Far off, they could see two more pyramids. This is amazing, said Nadim. I didn't think the pyramids were so big. Some people were pulling on long ropes. They were moving a big block of stone. That's amazing too, said Chip. I didn't know the pyramids were made with such big block of stone. Look over there, that's Verena. She pointed to a huge stone sphinx. Let's go and look at the sphinx, she said. They all began to run towards it. Flabby didn't go with them. He had seen a cat. The cat hissed at Flabby. Flabby couldn't stop himself. He chased it. It slipped onto some blocks of stone. Flabby jumped up too, but the cat was too fast for him. So Flabby chased the cat. She called to the others. They all went back to get Flabby, but he was stuck on blocks of stone. He couldn't get down. Oh, Flabby, you silly dog, said Biff. The children looked up at Flabby. He's long way up, but Nadim, I'll just have to climb up and help him down, said Biff. Then a man ran over. He looked at Flippy and gasped. The man called to some people. They ran over to the children. At first, they were talking and shouting. Then they all went quiet. What are they doing? Asked Biff. Why are they looking at us like this? The people put their hands together and raised them in the air. Then each. Then they sank down on their knees. They are bowing to us. They said they must think we are important. How strange, they knew them. The people were not bowing down to the children. They were bowing to Floppy. I don't believe it, whispered Chip. They must think Floppy is important. I wonder why. The people took Floppy away. The children followed Floppy, couldn't believe all this was happening to him. A magic adventure is bad enough, he thought, and now this. The people took Floppy to the king's palace. The king came out on the steps. In Egypt, a king is called Pharaoh. This Pharaoh looks very fierce. Everyone bowed down when they saw him. We'd better bow down to Sabef. We don't want to get into trouble. A man spoke to the Pharaoh. Great Pharaoh, he said, see what we have brought. The yellow dog gasped. The Pharaoh took Floppy inside the palace. Then he clapped his hands. Look after the yellow dog, he said. Give him whatever he wants. Said Floppy, I'm beginning to enjoy this adventure. I just don't get it, said Biff. Why are they making this fuss of Floppy? The Pharaoh clapped his hands again. Some people ran into the palace. One of them began to paint a picture of Floppy. Suddenly, they sneezed. The Pharaoh saw the children strangers in my palace. He shouted, how did they get in? A guard grabbed Chip and Dana. Another one grabbed Biff and Nedim. The guards took the children outside. They took them to one of the pyramids. The people were moving the big blocks of stone. You all look strong, said a guard. You can work here. The children had to help pull one of the big blocks. They had to put rollers down to slide it along. This is hard work, Mount Biff. These rollers are heavy. It was time for a rest. The children had to drink from a skin bag. Ah, said Chip, this water is warm and it this is funny too. I'd rather have an ice cold gun. The Egyptians were carving a giant stone block. The children had to pick up all the chips of stone that fell off. This is hard work too, said Nedim. It is no fun being an Egyptian slave. Anna looked at the carving. I wonder if they are making asparagus, she said. Asparagus was as the body of a lion, but that doesn't look like a lion tail. That tail looks familiar, said Viv. The carving was finished. I said it looked familiar, gasped Viv. It isn't asparagus at all. It is floppy. At that moment, the pharaoh came to see the carving. Some Egyptians carried Floppy. Suddenly, the magicky began to glow. Floppy jumped down and ran over to the sultan. Come back, yellow dog, called the pharaoh. I am glad it's time to go, said Floppy. It was all getting too much of a good thing. What an adventure, said Nadim. I didn't like me an adventure an Egyptian's life. Anna picked up the model sphinx. A sphinx has a lion's body and a man's head, she said, but this doesn't look a does look a bit like Floppy. The end.